I'm Alex from KiwiCo, and I was just playing with our transforming tops crate, and I realized this is like the perfect opportunity to do a tops battle. We have four contestants who have accepted our challenge. Our first contestant is Barley. He's really good with all the tools in the shop. He's pretty competitive, and he's very familiar with spinning objects. Next up, we have Cynthia. She's a 3D printing expert. She loves to make costumes, and she has actual experience battling robots. Let's see if that translates. Next is Jasmine. Her skills include cutting things with lasers. She took some physics in college, and she's really good at yo-yoing. And finally, we have Lisa. She's an artist, she's an out-of-the-box thinker, and she bakes the most beautiful cakes. All right, the rules are simple. You can use anything you like from the tops crate, but you have to use the stem of the tops, and it needs to work with our launcher. But modify it however you like. Try and get creative. It's going to be best 2 out of 3, and the last one standing wins. With the rules in place, it's time for everyone to get designing.
Part of what will allow a top to spin, or keep spinning, not start spinning, but to keep spinning, is weight. So I'm gonna focus on weight and how to distribute that weight most effectively.
So ultimately my strategy is cute chaos, and so cute that the other tops run away. They don't wanna hurt them.
For my design, I think I wanna make something that's gonna throw my opponents out of the ring. I think maybe adding some texture to the edge might help with that. Hopefully my top's the top of the competition.
Most of the power is coming from the key in the middle. And so I was thinking maybe if I am able to make it a little bit longer, it'll have even more space to pull and the force will be even stronger.
As everyone is designing their tops, they need to think about the physics behind what makes a top spin. And that's angular momentum. That's essentially what keeps a spinning object spinning. Everybody seems to know that weight is a really big part of this, so everybody's adding a lot of weight to their tops. That's awesome. Lisa is really focusing on speed. We can see that with the modification she made to her launcher. When she made the key a lot longer, that's going to allow her to put more energy into her launch so the top comes out spinning faster. And then Barley seems to be thinking a lot about balance and like evenly distributing his weight around his top.
So the first sample that I did was this very simple laser cut wood piece where I just pressed in the bearings. But I noticed that if I could get the weight a little further out and add more weight, it might rotate a little better.
I just got back from the laser cutter. I'm hoping that these little ridges in here can catch on my opponent's top and throw them off.
I sent my design over to the laser cutter. I'm thinking 16 inches will be a good length to give it a ton of extra speed. That way it's about double the normal size.
I made this cute, furry little cat, very adorable, but you can kind of see it doesn't really spin too well. It's very wobbly. So we're gonna fix that. We're gonna add some weight. We're gonna make it a bit more of a solid design. And instead of a cat, we're going with the claws. There's 4 claws here. Not biologically correct, but we're gonna use the rods to add some weight, put it in the 3D printed part and sandwich it together. Just like that.
So then this was my last version, fully integrated, 3D printed, with a total of 64 bearings. I also machined this metal pin that should reduce friction and allow it to spin much longer.
I'm also gonna add in some weight with these washers and glue it all together. And even the placement of the glue, I'm gonna try to get super even to make sure that all the weight is very evenly distributed in this top.
It looks a little silly next to the original one, but I think this is definitely gonna give me the edge that I need to win the competition.
Barley's top, Getting My Bearings, is our heaviest top. Most of that is due to the 64 bearings he hammered into the top's body. His design is also pretty unique in that it optimizes for friction by coming to a small steel point. He's hoping that this will help it spin for longer. Getting My Bearings weighs in at a whopping 52 grams. Cynthia's top, Claw NATO, features a cool 3D printed cat-inspired shape with a wooden base from the tops crate. She took advantage of the wooden base's existing geometry to encase a bunch of metal dowels. This keeps the weight low and evenly spread out. Claw NATO weighs in at 33 grams. Jasmine's top, the saw, has a fierce design. It's inspired by the teeth of a saw, and its jagged shape may catch its competitors, which she's hoping will throw them off balance. The saw weighs in at 31 grams. Lisa's very big, very huge top launcher and top is exactly what it sounds like. Lisa's hoping that the longer key will give her top more speed. We'll see if this is an advantage or a disadvantage. The very big, very huge top weighs in at 45 grams. It's going to be best 2 out of 3, and the last one standing wins. All right, it's competition time. All right, it's time for round one. Barley and Jasmine, take your places. Right. We have the saw versus getting my bearings. You ready?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Okay. Ready. 3, 2, 1, go! Nice. Oh. Oh. They're hitting. They're fighting.
Oh!
Oh! Wow! 3, 2, 1, go!
Oh.
3, 2, 1, okay. Go! Whoa!
Oh.
Nice! And the winner for round one is Barley! Congratulations.
Thank you.
We'll move you to the final round. All right, it's time for round two. We have Claw-Nado, and we have the very big, very huge top and top launcher. 3, 2, 1, go! Okay, you're bumping.
Ooh.
Nice, wow. Ooh. You're both staying really steady.
Wow, look at this.
Wow. These are good fighters.
Oh, come on. Whoa, yours is so stable.
Oh. Yeah. 3, 2, 1, go. Wow.
What?
The big, huge chop is aggressive.
Like moving so perfectly.
Wow.
Like it's moving.
And she's down. Congratulations, Claw-Nado. You're going to the finale.
Woohoo.
All right, we've made it to the third and final round. Barley, why do you think you made it here?
Weight, lots of it, and low.
Oh, okay. Mm. That's interesting.
And my secret.
Yeah. That's awesome. Okay, Cynthia, how do you think you made it to the final round?
I think mine's super stable, so it might have the edge, even though it's a little bit lighter.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
A lot lighter.
This is for the championship. Best 2 out of 3. Go ahead and put your tops in.
All right.
All right, in this corner, we have Getting My Bearings weighing in at 52 grams. And in this corner, we have Claw-Nado weighing in at 33 grams. It's anyone's game, best 2 out of 3. Let's go.
All right.
3, 2, 1, go. Okay.
Ooh.
Oh. Claw-Nado's looking a little off balance.
Yeah.
Gathering its center.
Ooh. I think the weight is winning out.
Yeah.
There's just enough hits.
Oh! And wipe out. Three, two, one, go!
That bounce.
Now it's just endurance.
That was a big hit. Oh no!
Good
battle.
Good job.
Good battle.
Thank you all so much for joining us and competing today, and congratulations to Barley!
Woo!
Yay!
That was super fun.
Wow, that was so much fun. To summarize why Barley's top ended up trouncing the competition, it's mainly because his top was the best in 3 categories: weight, balance, and friction. Barley's top was the heaviest, and he designed it so the weight was evenly distributed. That helps the top balance as it spins. He also went the extra mile by engineering his stem to come to a small steel point. That allows the top to be less impacted by friction and spin for even longer. Everyone else just used the original plastic stem, so Barley really set himself apart with this one. As you can see, there are a lot of elements that have to come together to control the physics of a well-spinning top. Excellent job, Barley. Getting my bearings is a beautiful creation. Thanks so much for watching. To see us next time, make sure to like and subscribe. See you later. Bye.